Hi everyone. I've logged in, I've gone live 4 minutes before. I just wanted to check whether you are able to hear me or not. Just put in the comments check section if you are able to hear me. If you are able to hear me, just put in the comment section now. निशांत एक बार ऑडियो चेक करो ना निशांत निशांत you start? Yeah, I did, but audio, I'm not sure. Hello, are you able to hear me? It starts at 7, no? Yeah, but I've gone 2 minutes before, it's okay. Many people have joined also. Are you able to hear me? Yes. But why is no one? You reply something on the chat, no?
Yes, the reply is there. Everyone is able to hear. Can start.
किधर मुझे ये नहीं आ रहा क्यों?
No, your this create a room so it won't come. Start.
Sure.
Yeah, sure. Coming. Stop.
They have replied as I'm.
Yeah,
Well,
yeah, yeah.
Dekho. Okay. Yeah. Should I start? Okay, fine. This part, the today's seminar will be on the radiology of lumbar spine. So as you all know, Zoom has been advised by the government not to use it. So we are using YouTube Live. YouTube Live is a bit slow. There is a lag between what I'm telling you and what you are seeing. There will be a lag of around 5 to 10 seconds. And second one, I will have to use my phone along with the laptop. Your chat I will be able to see on my phone, and the presentation I will be able to see on my laptop. So I want your feedback. If at all any point of time you are not able to hear me or something happens with the visuals, you let me know at the same time so that I will stop. Okay, so I'm starting my presentation. My presentation today is radiology of the lumbar spine. I'll be teaching this one from the physiotherapist point of view. I have divided into two or three sessions. As many people have said that radiology is something which we want to know in detail, so I have decided that I will not rush through this part of the topic, but I will be very slow in this part of my topic. Yeah, just give me a minute, right? Nishant.
Is
इट कमिंग मेरे इधर में नहीं आ रहा है
एक
मेरे इसमें नहीं आ रहा है
मिनट
या
फोन
I'm just checking whether everyone is receiving the live or not. Yeah. So let's go into this one. A brief introduction. So, okay, fine. One request, if I ask you whether it's working or not, someone reply me so that I'll have a proper feedback when it's working. First one is, you should know what is the spinal column. We are speaking about the vertebral column. The vertebral column is the most important part, and it has two main functions. One is, it provides protection from our spinal cord, which lies within the vertebral column. Second one, it helps in our movements. So in this session, we are dealing about regarding our lumbar spine. So when it comes to lumbar spine, this is our entire lumbar spine. Is it not working? Just give me a moment. Nishant is the Raju, no? They are saying it's not working. Many people are saying it's not working. That way it's not working. Udhar ek baar settings may change it so that we're not black out, no? Okay, two or three people have said, ye screen dark karke idhar laga do na mujhe. So this is the lumbar spine, and so the lumbar spine has five vertebrae. So we have L1, L2, we have the lumbar spine, which is L1, L2, L3, L4, L5. So we have the five lumbar vertebrae, and below the lumbar vertebrae we have the sacrum. So this is the lateral view of the lumbar vertebra. And this is the AP view. This is the posterior view. You're looking from behind. So these are the five vertebrae and one sacrum. So what you need to understand is, there are five vertebrae and one sacrum in the lumbosacral spine. Nishant, this is stopping. This is stopping means blackout. So before I go into proper anatomy of lumbosacral vertebra and its radiology, you see this brief animation, because this is very important for you to understand the entire pathology. So this is the vertebra, and this is one vertebra, this is the other vertebra. In between every two vertebrae, we have a soft cushion-like structure. This soft cushion-like structure is known as an intervertebral disc. Just like when you make a wall, we have bricks. In between bricks, we have cement. It's just like a cement in between two vertebrae. So this, whenever one vertebra wants to move on the other vertebra, we need to have a joint. This joint is the intervertebral disc. This disc has two components. It has outer covering, which is known as the annulus, and has an inner soft jelly-like material. This is known as the nucleus. Okay. So in between every two vertebrae, we have intervertebral disc. This disc and outer covering called as annulus, and an inner covering which is known as the nucleus. I'm not able to understand whether it's working or not. Let me check it once. Is it working, Nishant?
Yeah, it's working.
But here, it's not streaming at all for me. Okay, it's me nahi aa raha. Okay, with what name will this appear? You just reply. I will.
It's working itself.
Yeah. Chatting from my wife mobile. Dr. Vaishnavi. Yeah, मुझे वो दे दो ना.
Yeah.
Give me that one.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Hope it's working now. So, as I have told, in between each two vertebra, we have a soft disc-like material which is known as the intervertebral disc. This intervertebral disc has two components, an outer covering which is very tough, which is known as annulus. This annulus acts like a shock absorber. And an inner soft jelly like material which is known as nucleus, and this nucleus acts like a ball bearing. And this nucleus acts like a ball bearing. This ball bearing helps in making your movements. If you have to flex, if you have to extend, this ball bearing comes into action. So what happens when there's a prolapsed intervertebral disc? Just continue to see the animation. So with the degeneration, we have a small tear in the overlying annulus. See when it happens. So what happens in the slip disc? So we'll see. So there's a tear in the annulus. Because of this tear, patient will now complain of back pain. In the second stage, it protrudes out. Now it is known as prolapsed intervertebral disc. At this point of the pain, patient will still have back pain, but because the nerve is not compressed, it will not have leg pain. In the next stage, the compression further goes up and now it compresses the spinal nerve. Because of this compression, the spinal nerve becomes red, which is known as inflammation, and now the patient will start complaining of pain radiating along the leg. So this back pain with pain radiating along the leg is known as sciatica. With further compression, patient will complain of numbness, weakness or paralysis, and bowel and bladder disturbances. So hope you have understood what is a slip disc, how does it cause weakness. So now let us come to the proper anatomy. Before I tell you the radiology of lumbosacral spine, let me tell you the first anatomy of the lumbosacral spine. Basically, you can imagine that from anterior to posterior. You will see how is the vertebral column made. There is a pillar-like support in the anterior portion. Then similarly, there is one more pillar in the posterior portion. There is a connection between the anterior and posterior one. Okay. So we have three portions. So we have the anterior portion, we have the middle column. Both of them are connected by a middle column. Anterior and posterior, which are connected by a middle column. So this middle column is known as the pedicle. The anterior column is made up of the vertebral body. And these are the posterior elements, which are more made up of lamina and spinous process. You can imagine our vertebral column. You can imagine our vertebral column just to be like, you can imagine our vertebral column just to be like a wall. As you say, a wall is made up of a number of bricks. Okay, each bricks, in between each two bricks, you have cement. So similarly, this is one unit. This is similar to one brick. One brick has three portions: an anterior portion, a posterior portion, and the middle portion, which are joined by middle portion. So then we have the, this is one unit. Then this is the second unit. Okay, so how are each unit to other unit connected? We need some cement-like structure. This cement-like structure in the anterior portion is known as the intervertebral disc. This is the intervertebral disc. In the posterior portion, the laminae are connected to each other by hook-like components. There is a hook coming from above vertebra. There is a hook coming from the lower vertebra. They interlock. So these are known as the articular process. This is the inferior articular process of superior vertebra. And this will be the superior articular process. So you understood, the anterior portion of the vertebral body, which are connected by the intervertebral disc, and in the posterior component, we have the laminae, which are connected by the hooks. These are the interarticular process. So let's come. So coming to each vertebra. See, if you have to understand the radiology, you will have to understand the anatomy also. So first let us understand anatomy in brief. As I've told you, this is the lumbar vertebra, which I'm seeing from the side. So you need to have an anterior, you need to have an anterior column, you need to have a posterior column and a middle column. So this is our anterior column. This is our posterior column, and they are connected by middle column. So what is formed is seen in the anterior column. This is the vertebral body. So the anterior column is formed by the vertebral body. The posterior column, we have a spinous process. This is a spinous process, and this is the lamina. And how are two adjacent vertebral bodies connected? They are connected by hooks, I said. This hook, which is projecting upwards, is known as superior articular process. This unites with the inferior articular process of the superior vertebra. Similarly, this is the inferior articular process, which unites with the superior articular process of the inferior vertebra. So this is the posterior portion. As Dr. Sabha has asked me, so this is the posterior portion. Posterior portion actually has two components. The one which is protruding back is known as the spinous process. And this one is known as the lamina. So from anterior posterior of the body, and we have a body which got connected to the pedicle. From the pedicle, we have the lamina. From the lamina, what is projecting backwards is the spinous process. So from this junction of the lamina and the spinous process, we have the thing, hook-like structure projecting upward, which is known as superior articular process, and a hook-like process which is projecting downwards, which is known as inferior articular process. So this picture you should remember. If you don't identify this picture, you will not be able to understand. This is the structure of the body when I'm seeing from up. This is what we call as the axial section. So similarly, this is the anterior one. This is the posterior one. So from anterior to posterior, we have the vertebral body, which is connected through pedicles. These are the middle column. This ring-like structure is the lamina. And this one, which is projecting back, is the spinous process. So in the anterior elements, we have the vertebral body, only one. In the middle component, in the middle column, we have the pedicle, which is also only one. Whereas in the posterior components, we have the lamina and the spinous process. And these are united to adjacent structures through the articular process. This is the superior articular process, and below, when you see from below, it is the inferior articular process. But yeah, nothing is coming here. Okay, now let us compare. Now you have understood what is the structure of individual vertebra. So let me draw individual vertebra. So this is one vertebra which is having a vertebral body. This is the middle column, which is the pedicle, and this is the lamina, which is articulating with the superior articular faces and the inferior articular faces. Are you all able to hear me? Any one of you give me a message? Okay. Now make it more interactive. So I will be touching few things. You will have to tell me what it is. So what is this structure which I have drawn? What is this structure which I have drawn? So structure one, which I have labeled, what is it? I want answer from everyone. Structure one. And I want you to tell what is structure two. Yeah. Now what is structure two? I may be going slow, but this is very important. Okay, so structure one is vertebral body. So what is structure two? Now speak about structure two. Yeah, structure two, spinous process. Now what is structure three? What is structure three? So structure two was spinous process. Yeah, structure three is pedicle. Okay, now try to show me what is this structure. This is very important. What is this structure? This structure is four. This structure is the connection between the superior articular process and the inferior articular process. What is structure four? This is connection between the superior articular process and the inferior articular process. Now, this junction between the superior articular process and the inferior articular process is known as pars interarticularis. This is very important for all the physiotherapists. Okay, I want all of you to answer this once again. The structure 4, which is seen between, I'm drawing it at every level. The structure 4, which is the junction of superior articular process and the inferior articular process, is known as pars interarticularis. No, now don't answer me. Structure 4 is pars interarticularis. I want everyone to remember it. Okay, and what is structure 5? I'm drawing this structure. Can you say an opening? What is the structure 5? So what is the structure 5? So I'm waiting for reply for structure 5. No. Zygomaticus joint is not. Just try to follow me. Okay. Structure 4 is pars interarticularis, and what is structure 5? Make a guess. Structure 5 is the neural foramina. structure 5 is known as the neural foramina. So once you have seen the lumbosacrum from the lateral view, you also have to recognize the AP view. When in the AP view, one structure which you have to recognize is the one which is exactly in the midline. The one exactly. Someone is asking me what is the difference between zygopiphyseal joint and the paracentral articularis. Zygopiphyseal joint is usually not spoken of in the lumbosacral spine. There are very small joints which are not clinically important, but zygobiphyseal joint are more important in the thoracic spine and the cervical spine. So let us not speak about it. Nishant, it got struck. It's not working, Nishant. Yes, good. Excellent connection with her. वायशु का चाहती है फिर से स्ट्रीम स्टॉप करके ऑन करो. हमारे इंटरनेट का कुछ प्रॉब्लम है क्या? नहीं, नो इट्स
इट स्टार्टेड. यू कैन गो.
ओके, इज इट फाइन विद एवरीवन नाउ? शुड आई कंटिन्यू? Yeah, again, it's streaming.
Yes, it's coming.
वैसे कोई ये सब नहीं होता यार. I will stand your strength.